The terminal end of our network is basically a person who is trying to communicate over the air to another person. And the vocal cords generate an acoustic signal, and that acoustic signal is nothing but some vibration or the vibration in the air molecules. So these air molecules and their vibrations are incident on the microphone. So the first task that the cell phone does is basically convert an acoustic signal into an electrical signal. And this is done by means of a transducer. So the output of transducer is a continuous time signal. So as a second step, what we need is we need to convert that continuous time analog signal into a digital signal. So this is done by means of an analog to digital converter, which is basically available on the circuit board in our cell phones. So until the second block, the signal that we have is basically of low frequency. Why is it of low frequency? Because the spectrum of our voice is from 100 hertz to roughly about 4 kilohertz, right? So it is of low frequency. Over here, an important point to consider is that at low frequencies, we would have a very big antenna, because frequencies are inversely proportional to the wavelength, and wavelength is directly proportional to the antenna size, right? So in short, the frequency is inversely proportional to the antenna size. So if we have a low frequency content, we would eventually need a very big antenna to transmit the signal, and hence that is not possible. So we need to modulate the signal to a higher frequency. Besides the antenna size, we also need to super heterodyne or shift the frequency spectrum to an appropriate frequency bands set forth by the operators and regulators. This necessitates the use of RF modulators. So these RF modulators are dependent on the technology, whether you're using 2G or 3G or 4G. So these RF modulators translate our signal in frequency to an appropriate band. So once it is translated, eventually we have an antenna, and that antenna is basically transmitting an electromagnetic wave out of our cell phone on towards the base transceiver station, which is shown over here. Specifically, our cell phones are connected with these antennas, these rectangular antennas, by means of electromagnetic waves. So this over-the-air interface is termed as UM interface in GSM networks. These base transceiver stations can be observed on roadsides and on the rooftops and other places. Note that this base transceiver station or this unit is just the outdoor unit. We also have an indoor unit. So coming back to the antenna, each antenna is connected with an IF cable, which you can observe over here, and that cable goes to the indoor unit. Let us have a look into the indoor unit. So this indoor unit is basically installed inside a small cabin or a small room. And over here we have different cabinets where several equipments are installed. Since all of these are active units, we have rectifiers and battery banks which are ensuring the power supply. So coming back to the IF cable over here, which was coming from the antennas. So this IF cable comes into this cabinet. So let us look what is inside this cabinet. So these IF cables are connected to different modules inside this cabinet, which represent different cells, right? So we have one cell with these antennas, and then we have another cell over here. At the back end of this, we would have another cell. So all of these rectangular antennas are connected to this cabinet. The output of this cabinet can be a simple Ethernet twisted pair cable, which is punched over here on this port. So this unit serves as an interface between this cabinet and the rack over here, in which we have a transmission indoor unit. While this is the back side of transmission indoor unit, let us look into the front side of this, which is over here. There are at least two ways in which we can relay this data coming from the user to the antenna, to the base transceiver station, eventually to this unit and over here. So the first method in which we can relay this information to a core network, such as a base switching center or a main switching center in a GSM network, the first method can be by means of a microwave link. So over here we have several interfaces which are identifying various microwave links. Note that the microwave links are over here. The circular antenna is basically identifying a microwave link. Just to recap, the rectangular antenna was communicating with the mobile station over here. The circular antenna communicates with other base transceiver stations or with the core networks. Over here, we intend to put forward our request to the core network, right? So assuming that this board or this IF cable is linking to this antenna, and eventually this antenna connects with the core network, right? So while these are the hardware units, let us look into the software aspect of this device, that is the transmission block. So specifically for this board, we have a near end radio terminal, which is this one, and we would have a far end radio terminal. So that is the same microwave at an other end, which could be a core network or another station. The green color identifies that the links are working perfectly right now. So in case there are issues, you would have some reds appearing over here. So let us look into what these softwares mean. Starting with this MMU2C, this block. So this block identifies the card, this card, right? And then you have an IF cable, which is over here. So this connects with the antenna. And then we have a radio device, which is over here at the back end of this dish, circular dish. And this is the radio frequency interface. TX identifies the transmit power, and RX identifies the receive power. Similar structure is on the far end terminal. Again, note that we have interfaced this LAN cable with the microwave, and we intend to send it to the core network. Another way of sending the data to core network is by means of fiber optics, and that fiber optic again has two options. The first option could be by means of fiber over the air, that is again through a microwave link, and the second option is an actual and physical fiber optic cable that is laid between base transceiver station and the base switching center or the core network. The core networks have several features, so they include call forwarding, roaming services, and taking care of handover procedures, billing control, authentication, and so on and so forth. So once the so-called call is over here in the core network, then the reverse process starts. And the reverse process is dependent on the location of the other end user. So this was the first end user. Now the core network would decide where the other user is based on the home location register or the visiting location register, details of which are given in the architecture of GSM. And eventually the call is headed towards the base